basically deals with blood disorders, blood cancers, and area of stem cell and bone marrow transplant. Now, what is stem cell? Stem cell is basically the mother cell or the father cell of all the cells that we find in the blood, like the WBC, the RBC, and the platelet. It is available, the stem cell may be, this is the hematopoietic stem cell. There are stem cells elsewhere also, like in the cord. You have the cord naive stem cells, and there are various types of stem cells again, like the mesenchymal stem cells, and otherwise the pluripotent stem cells. Now, pluripotent stem cell can differentiate into anything. It can become hair, it can become an intestine, lung, anything. So that's the future that we are looking at. Now, what are the present uses of stem cells? Stem cells are used in various fields, but the only accepted legal indication is supposed to be hematopoietic stem cell transplant for using bone marrow derived stem cells and even the cord blood derived stem cells. There are various uses of mesenchymal stem cells which are beyond transplant, including you use it for injection into joints or wherever it's possible, but these are all under experimental use. Today, ICMR, or Indian Council of Medical Research, feels that there is only one legal indication for using stem cell, that is bone marrow transplant or stem cell transplant. Now, what is this procedure of stem cell transplant? It is basically a procedure where a patient with a disorder will get this stem cell after getting a chemotherapy, and then when these stem cells get into his body, they basically become the RBC, the WBC, and the platelet. Now, what are the various indications of being bone marrow transplant? The first indication in this country is thalassemia major, and if the thalassemia major doesn't respond to novel therapies that are available today, then we can consider having a bone marrow transplant or a cord blood transplant from an unrelated or related source. Similarly, there are leukemias which have become refractory, which have come after chemotherapy, that we can do stem cell transplant. Lymphomas after they have relapsed. Myelomas, we usually do something called autologous stem cell, where the patient himself is the donor for self. Now, these are the multiple uses of stem cell, but stem cells would probably become the only treatment without side effects in the years to come, and hopefully we would have an array of products, array of indications where we could be using stem cells, not in experimental setting, but in therapeutic setting. So hopefully in the next few years, we will see a bigger boom of stem cells.